purely interested in selection bias. In selection bias, we have that our sample population do not represent exactly the population in that we are trying to represent. Could be the whole population of a state, for example. This sampling bias usually is because of a specifically in the selection that we are selecting the people that are going to be enrolled in the study. Could be, for example, in selecting which people are going to study for a screening in mammography. If we just say that can come whatever person wants to come, then possibly the woman that have a history of breast cancer are going to be enrolled in that. That is, that we have more percentage of women that have history of breast cancer than normal women. And so for that, and if those women have a history of breast cancer, a family history of breast cancer, probably they are going to have breast cancer. And so the prevalence of breast cancer is going to be increased, but because in our study we have more women with breast cancer history than in the whole population. Other selection bias is attrition bias. This is when we lose the following of participants in the study. Could be a placebo group or a control group and the other group with treatment or whatever. And we lose someone of these, and so we would have a bias because we would not know what happened to the people that we lose here. The other kind of selection bias is Bergson bias, when the information or the data is taken from hospitals. Or the other example is in assignment, when we are assigning which person is going to get the treatment and which person is going to have the placebo. If we say this person that has the severe form of cancer is going to have the treatment, at the end maybe we are going to have a bias because we give the treatment to the most severe type of cancer people. So in that case is random assignment. That is, let's say we flip a coin and we say this person goes in treatment and this person goes in placebo, because to reduce the bias, not because we don't want to give the treatment that we think that is going to work to the people that have the disease or the severe disease. No, because in the other way we are going to be biased and we could think that the treatment didn't work, or that the treatment worked when it really doesn't.